The noise, and welcome back to another episode of Keys Couch. No, I'm just kidding. Well, it's basically Keys Couch these days because we in the house. But Kicking It With Key, where we share our journeys to light the pathway for others through tips and hacks for everyday struggles. And that is what I'm here to bring you today. Because today we are talking all about productivity. And this is not going to be your normal productivity video. I'm not giving you a whole bunch of tips on how to be the most productive during this time, because the reality is none of us know how to handle this because we have not been through it before. And the elephant in the room is COVID-19, right? We know we're dealing with it. We know that it's really been hard on a lot of families, a lot of my friends, a lot of my family members know somebody who is struggling or has somebody in their life that is struggling with this health crisis. And it's affecting so many other aspects of our lives, one being the fact that we are really not supposed to be out in the city running around. If you are, you need to get your drill in the house. But that's not the point of what we're talking about today. Today, we're talking about redefining productivity for yourself. And honestly, everybody and their mama think that they know what's best for folks during this time. For example, there was actually a tweet going around, and I'm going to display it on the screen for you right now. And on this tweet is basically saying that if you're not accomplishing all these things, writing a book, doing all this stuff, then you're not doing anything, and like, you're not being productive, and you're not using this time wisely. And the frustrating thing about that for people is that people are dealing with this in all different ways because they're all being affected differently. And so today I'm going to give you five tips on how you can redefine productivity for yourself, because it's really about you. And I truly believe that there is a difference between workplace productivity and what we deem as our personal productivity. Because workplace productivity is basically the ability to do as much as you can in a possible or given time. And honestly, I choose quality over quantity. And so that's why that workplace productivity isn't always the most positive way to get the results that you want. So let's go ahead and jump into the first tip of how you can redefine productivity for yourself and be the best version of you. Because that's what I'm here to help you do. Cut that noise and do your very best to be your highest self. So let's go ahead and jump into it now. All right, let's dive into tip number one. And tip number one is about goal setting. So, and this is not your typical goal setting, because you need to think about what is your goal over the course of this time that you want to be productive and the time that we are in the house. Because the reality is we don't know how long we are actually going to be in the house. There's a lot of unpredictability that comes with this. But also, you want to think about goals that will make you feel like you've accomplished things during this time. And so the question you should be asking yourself is, what is the goal? And you want to make this specific to your personal life outside of work, right? So yes, it can have some work implications, but the point of it is to get to what really works for you as a person. Not what your boss would want for you, not what your parents would want, not what your kids or your husband or your wife, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, or anything else. Not what they will want for you. What do you want for yourself during this time? And try to list a couple of things. What are some goals that you have for yourself, or things you've been wanting to do, but you haven't done it because you didn't have the time? Or personal areas of your life you wanted to work on, but you haven't had the time. So redefining productivity for yourself is first starting off with setting some goals that are just about you and not including outside opinions in that process. So think about it, ask yourself that question, and keep in mind that the people that are pressing these issues of like, be productive, create a side hustle, do all of that, some of them are operating from a position of privilege, because they may be in a position to actually create a second business. They may be in a position to pay their bills. But if you're a person that has lost their job from this, has sick family members, has kids, all these other things, are lacking technology or anything during this time, then that type of life may not be for you. So think about goals that will fit with where you are in your life, okay? All right, let's jump into number two. All right, tip number two is all about your why. And you all know I love to get to the root of stuff. I like to talk about why things are the way they are. And I feel like that has helped me tremendously as a person and to continue to grow and evolve into the woman I want to be. So you have to ask yourself why you're doing it. So after you think about the goals you want, think about why you want to do those things. Or think about why some of the things that you're thinking you need to do, why do you feel like you need to do them? And you want to get to the bottom of that, because that'll help you decide, okay, what do I see as productivity? Does it have a lot to do with my work? Does it have a lot to do with the way I treat and deal with my family day to day? Does it have to have stuff to do with, like, have I cooked? Did I clean? Did I read a book? Am I doing yoga? Like, what is productive for you? And so ask yourself why. And this brings me back to that quality versus quantity perspective that I talked about earlier. When you think about quality, you're thinking about making sure that whatever you're doing yields the results that you want. And so that's why the goal setting is so critical. But then the quantity piece is you have to realize that just because you did a lot of stuff, I don't know if you've ever had a day where you did accomplished all these things, but the majority of your list of the to-do list was frivolous stuff. Stuff that didn't even impact you personally, didn't impact the type of work or the type of person you're going to be. And to be honest, I don't want to waste my days like that. And this time away from the hustle and bustle of life may be a good time to reassess what you find as productive, in even in your work life, even in your family life, right? Your social life. Do you feel like you waste a lot of time? These are things that you get to decide for you. And that's the best part about this. Even though this is a super terrible situation for us to be in, gratitude will help you kind of push forward the things that you can take from this that will be positive, right? The other thing is, what is valuable to you? Like, what do you see as valuable? Making a list of the things that you value most in your life might really help you with deciding what you deem as productible. Productible. Y'all, what is wrong with my mouth? Productive. Because I read an article recently where they were talking about how their family and friends and spending time with people they love had jumped to the top of their priority list because they realized that those were the things that they really truly enjoy and that they loved and that they had not been putting enough time into. So consider that, and let's move on to tip number three. All right, so guys, tip number three is about staying present. So this is probably one of my favorite ones because I've really been working on staying present since around this time last year or a little bit before, because I really do understand the importance of feeling the moment. And I think a lot of times what I have done is I'm thinking, because I'm such a planner and I'm trying to do things a certain way and make sure I'm doing the right things with my life, right? And trying to, you know, fulfill my purpose. Oftentimes I'm thinking about the future, what's next, all that. And personally, you know, just a little transparency, I am one of the people that is technically out of work, right? I wasn't really let go, but we don't have any dance instruction happening right now because schools are closed and they're prioritizing academic education, which I'm not really surprised by, because, you know, the school systems don't tend to believe that the arts education is as important because it's not tested. And I know that as an educator myself, because I've been in the system. But that's not the point. The point is, I know that I am in a position of confusion and a little bit of anxiety because I'm not getting any money right now, right? That stimulus check was great and I'm thankful, thank you Jesus, but I am still kind of struggling and I'm just kind of moving through this in the best way that I know how, right? Trying to apply for stuff, reaching out, blah, 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 all these things. And then continuing to do Kicking It With Key to keep the spirits up and to continue to support you guys. So staying present is so critical for me right now, because if you think too much into the future, you no longer can enjoy anything that's happening right now. And to be honest, there are still some really good things that are happening in my life as I'm in the house. So continue to be present. Actually take stock of what's happening right now in your life. And one way you can do that is to set an intention. So an intention is basically deciding what you want your day to look like. And you can set your intentions at different points in the day, right? I like to set an intention during my journaling in the morning. Some people set intentions while they're getting their coffee in the morning. Some people set afternoon intentions. Some people set their intentions at night. It's up to you how you want to go about it. And if y'all are interested, I actually can do a separate episode just talking about intentions. If you drop that in the comments below, I got y'all. Let me know. I also am really planning to do a separate episode about journaling, but that's a whole nother piece because I think that is so critical and it's changing my life right now. But make sure you set that intention because it will help you be present. And one of my professors when I was in college at Howard University used to say, be present in time and space. And it's important that you're physically present and that you're mentally present and that you enjoy the moment that you're in, because it also reminds you that you're still existing. Because that can be really hard when you're not spending time with the people that you usually spend time with. So I'm sending you love and hoping that you'll do that. Tip number four is up next. All right, tip number four. And this is one that I have struggled with. Okay, so tip number four is reminding yourself that you are not defined by your job or your career. You are a person outside of that. Whatever job you have right now, you will be you without that job. And if you don't feel that way, then that is an area of growth for you. So a great example of this is I left the traditional classroom to move to the dance classroom. Granted, it's still education and I still really love spending time with my kiddos and all the people, the students and teachers that I work with. But I started to feel like I was kind of not my full self because I wasn't teaching the same way that I was doing before, right? And I started to feel like when I was watching other people still teach and do it in the system that I used to be in, I felt a way. And I was trying to figure out why that was. And I realized it's because I started to define who I was based off of my job as an elementary teacher in the public school system. Very specific. Because that was something that I always said I would do and what I wanted to do. And I realized that part of the reason that I defined myself that way is because other people heard me say this and kind of held me to that standard. And so what we have to realize is you are not defined. bloopers. You are not defined by the job that you have. And I feel like that is more clear now than ever, right? Because some of us aren't even working the jobs that we cared so much about because it's not possible. And some of us are not working the jobs in the same way that we did before. And so you don't want to let career and money and all that start to define you as a human being, because without all of it, if the Lord took all that away from you, then who are you outside of it? Seriously, ask yourself, who am I outside of all of these indicators that people use to tell me who I am, or the indicators I use to tell myself who I am? You got to know who you are at your core outside of all these things, because you're more. You're more than your job. You're more than that. And what Janae Iko slash she said, I'm more than my emotions. You are more than your job, baby. You are. So keep that in mind. And let's move on to the last tip, tip number five, for how you can redefine productivity for you. Okay? Period. All right, so this is like an elementary tip, but it's always good to be reminded of this one because I feel like a lot of times we just forget. So tip number five is to do your best and give grace to yourself and others, you know, if that comes up. Do your best and give grace. Nobody has been through this before. No person that's living right now has been through this particular pandemic and has had to deal with these exact circumstances that we're in right now. So you need to stop being so hard on yourself. Honestly, the guilt tripping, the calling yourself lazy, all that has to stop. Now, I want to be very clear I want this to be one of the things that you take away as well. I am not telling y'all to not be productive. I am not out here telling y'all that because, see, there's still a purpose over your life. There's still a vision for your life. There's still a calling on your life. So you can't just be sitting around this entire time. But what you can do is change the method to the madness, right? The method to how you're going to get towards your purpose. And so you do your best. And you know what your best is. So give your best daily, right? And if you stumble, take a deep breath, say a prayer, meditate, do some yoga, whatever you need to do, get back on track, and don't punish yourself for it. Because at the end of the day, if you do your best is going to be enough every time. Your best will be enough for yourself, because it's supposed to be. Your best will be enough for these teachers and these classes and these jobs that are temporary. And your best will be enough for God, because He loves you and He wants your best. And when He sees you giving it, He blesses you accordingly. I truly believe that, right? And so also give grace. You need to give grace to other people. Let's start there. When you give grace to other people, it's a lot easier for people to give grace to you. We are all dealing with this at the rate and understanding and knowledge as much as we can. And one of my affirmations this week has been, I am doing the best I can with the information I have at this time. Because I don't know when the next time I will be able to go outside. Because even when they open, what they say, open outside back up, I might have to wait a little longer because I have an autoimmune disease that literally can be debilitating at times. So you add COVID in there and then we got a whole problem, and I ain't trying to have no problems, child. See, I'm trying to be wise. But anyway, keep these things in mind. Set these goals. Know your why. Stay present. Know that you're not defined by your career. And do your best and give some grace. And the recipe that I always think works for how you deal with relationships and with yourself is accountability with some love. If you hold yourself accountable but put some love on it, it'll create situations. And holding your people accountable, like if somebody's asking you to hold them accountable during this time, accountability with love breeds real good relationship, and that means relationship with yourself too. Hold yourself accountable, but also do it with love. Because we have things to accomplish, yes, but you are going through a pandemic. Take a deep breath, okay? And relax, okay? I offer some resources in the comments if you need it. Make sure you check them out. Subscribe, y'all. Continue, because I'm going to continue talking about things like this and supporting you, even outside of, you know, COVID, right? And we're going to move on to the dedication and some announcements with this girl. So let's go ahead. All right, let's move on to the dedication. So today I'm actually going to dedicate this episode to Elise. And I feel like I've dedicated an episode to her before. But she's my good sis that I met in college, but also like spent time with her at church. And she was on the Save This podcast with me for a while. And then she eventually left and went back to Michigan. But she has an amazing YouTube channel. And she's such an inspiration to watch. But she really inspired this video because she actually posted a YouTube video on productivity. And talking about hacks that she used. And I thought it was really cool. And then I thought even further because I kept seeing a lot of tweets talking about what people should be doing. And I thought that, you know, coupling redefining productivity with her productivity hacks would be a really good recipe to help people. So you make sure you all, I'm going to tag it in the comments. So make sure you all go check that out. She's does a wonderful job of explaining everything. And it's just really good and like stuff that you can just use in your everyday life. All right. So thanks, Elise, girl. Moving on to announcements with Keys. So I always have lots of announcements. But my first announcement is about the Reformist Pipeline. And I love to talk about these guys because they are making me feel so connected still to everything that's going on with schools. And I think it's really important during this time to think about how this affects kids, which is why I talked about self-care for teachers and students in my last episode, which I'll link in the comments, so check it out. But I really love the Reformist Pipeline because they really talk about issues that are critical to our babies and to our teachers. And child, they're talking about why kids shouldn't be learning at home and how hard that can be and all that. It's a lot. But I'm excited for what they're talking about coming up on this Monday. So when you see this, Monday will be tomorrow. So make sure you go check them out, and they will give you a call to action. So listen to the very end of the episode so that you can make sure you hear the call to action and actually do something about it. Don't just be sitting there listening and don't do nothing. Y'all, come on. Anyway, so hit up Lindsay Black and Jihad as they talk about our babies and our teachers and our lives and everything that's affected by the school system. Okay? Moving on to the next announcement. So the next announcement is that you need to make sure you're checking out Save Dish, where we have conversations about being young, Christian, and imperfect, because we are imperfect. And we've been talking about unlearning. And I think that episode is probably one of the best episodes we talked about so far. And many of the things I talk about on my channel are about unlearning and getting rid of things that don't help us, that don't, and I don't really like the phrase that don't serve us. I mean, I get it, but things that don't enhance our well-being and push us to go forward and make choices that'll be best for our lives. And last but certainly not least, I am doing lives every Thursday at 8:30, and I've had some phenomenal guests. I've had the creator of Era Vista Planner, okay, Gigi. I've had Sammy Approve, also known as Chelsea, but you all know her as Sammy. She's super cool, amazing woman. We had an awesome conversation, just so much fun. And then last but not least, I've talked to Jamie from The Blind Misfit, and you all need to go check them out. I'll also link their stuff in the comments as well, because I want to make sure that you all have all this stuff and you can access them. And honestly, I'm about bringing resources to y'all, so any way that I can do that, that is what I'm going to do. I love y'all for real, and this has been another episode of Kicking It with Key, also known as Key's Couch, because we on the couch with it for a while. Because I actually really wanted to go out and eventually film out in the world or go to... Not the point. We're doing the best we can with what we have. And remember to define productivity for yourself. Hit me up. And I'm here every other Sunday at 7 p.m. And on Instagram and Facebook live at 8:30 every Thursday. Child, listen, I'm getting all connected to these ripped pants. But yeah, y'all. That's all I got for y'all today. I'm going to go and remember to cut the noise and live your very best life. Love y'all for real. Bye. I'm still here. Great.